Hello there, and welcome to part 14 of my Dead Rising 72-hour mode playthrough. And I wonder how many more videos I'll be filming before I call it quits for this game for today, because I don't want to get ahead of myself like I had the other times. Anyways, I guess we're just going to goof around for a bit, because we don't have any other tasks to do other than the last resort, which is a story mission. Anywho, what else can I talk about? Oh, Otis.
I spotted a guy with long hair over one of the women's clothing shops in Wonderland Plaza. He's holding a Molotov cocktail. You better be careful.
Oh god, that guy. The long-haired punk. I've been dreading this day ever since I started playing this game again. The psychopath himself is not a huge deal, but it's what happens after the fight that's a pain in the ass, because he's actually a psychopath that you have the potential to save. The main problem is he's really hard to save because of the aiming mechanics in this game. How to save him and what happens, I'll leave that for you to figure out, because I don't want to spoil it. Because I'm not spoiling McSpoilerton. I think I'll go to Colombian Roastmasters and get some OJ before I do that mission. Whoa. So yeah, all the cultists are gone, which is a real good thing. All we have to deal with is all of these zombies. I was never a fan of all the special zombie types they introduced in Dead Rising 2. I just felt they were really unnecessary. There's probably all sorts of special zombies in Dead Rising 3. Being that it's made by the same developer. Okay. We are well prepared for the events ahead of us. Whoa! Should have picked up a queen, but ah well, it's not too big a deal. I don't remember if that activates, if a cutscene activates as soon as I enter the entrance plaza or when I get to the store where they're at. I think it's whenever I'm at the store. Also, I forget, is this an entrance plaza or a Wonderland plaza? I don't know. I guess it's an entrance plaza. Now I know. Wait. The guide arrow is pointing that way. But there's a mystery over here. That must be towards the... Hold on, let me see this. Yeah, that must be towards the security room where there's another quest. That must be where it means, because the security room's in Entrance Plaza. So, never mind. Looks like we're going to Wonderland. Could have gone to the washroom shortcut, but oh well. We'll take the more scenic route. Full of zombies and nightmares. Got all sorts of time to complete this quest. But we'll get it done now. While I'm at Wonderland Plaza, I think I'll pick up a small chainsaw or two. Just because they're really handy. McGill. Oh, this is the drunk. Yeah. Woohoo! Party on, man. That could have been a better pee-pee moment. This guy's full of it. I almost want to crack a bottle of wine over his head. It's too hard. What's too hard? Wake up. Wake up, dude, and then keep doing this until you wake up. Look how much blood there is. Don't you think he would have bled out by now? Oh. I guess I'm doing it again.
Mouth too hard.
What's he talking about? Why am I wasting my time with you? Oh, Otis.
Sounds too hard.
Cosmetic shop in Wonderland Plaza.
Sorry about that.
So yeah, now you're sorry. Drunk. He just healed his health. Otis! Don't cut me off like that. I didn't cut you off. What are you talking about? Goddamn Otis getting all pissy. Sick man. We're probably gonna barely make the last story mission. I hope that's not the case. There's still cult posters all over the place, even though they're all gone. So, when does the cutscene start? Probably when I get to the store. Yep. It's nice that there's not many zombies here, though, for now. It's probably just because of the quest. Oh. Okay, here we go. It's in here. This is creepy.
My God! What have you ever done to you?
You do it all the time! You look at me and then laugh! Who's there? Stay back! Stay back! Getting
This guy is profoundly disturbed. And disturbing. So, I'll just tell Gil to go wait in there, because he's useless as a drunk. See, Paul is a total coward. He'll fight you, but he's so passive about it. Oh, Leroy's in the distance there. So we took care of him in no time flat.
Get away from me!
And somehow we warped back into the shop. His crotch is on fire. So you can't actually aim with this thing. I think he's gonna die. Is there another one? Yeah, he's dead. Oh well. Oh, there's another fire extinguisher in here. I think I've only saved, Paul once throughout my entire... No, I am not giving you that. I'm not giving you that either. Gimme. Fine, you can have the sledgehammer, but nothing else. Get out of my way, please. So yeah, unfortunately we weren't able to save Paul. Because he's another sympathetic psychopath. See, while they're congested and they can't move, I'll go take care of Leroy because those guys are just getting in my way. Although we can actually take the shortcut in this place.
My apologies.
My apologies. Oh, they're here.
Sorry about that.
He's infected. That's why.
My fault.
Leroy McKenna. Oh yeah, Gil's drunk, I forgot. So they'll wait over there. So I'll loop around.
Come on!
Get these guys to come with me. How long have I been filming for? 14 minutes. Let's go, fellas. You know, fellas. It's like part of a line that I remember from King of the Hill. Great old TV show. That's not the washroom. It's down here. Oh my god.
Freak!
Go over there. It sounds like nails grinding against the chalkboard. That's how annoying it sounds.
Come on!
Mindy? Okay, good. Not having too much trouble so far. There's the washroom. I swear though, they're so annoying because they get snagged by one zombie as they're walking past them. So everyone wait here.
Over there!
Watch, they're all gonna get caught up in the entrance. What's going on here? Oh, Leroy! There. That's my answer to that. You get the boot. You get the brogue kick from Sheamus. What are you doing? Why do you stop? Is your first reflex in the middle of a horde of zombies to stop moving? If I did that, I'd be dead.
Follow me!
Or rather, I'd be undead. I'd be turned undead. Alright. Look at Mindy. She's like covering her head whenever she's walking past the drunk. It's like, ugh, I don't want to be near him.
Follow me!
So, thankfully we got this, all those quests done in a timely manner. Aren't you glad? I'm glad. I know I am. All the tomfoolery we've had in this playthrough so far. We're actually getting to the end, too. We're getting quite close to the end. They could be moving faster, but at least they're not getting snagged. Alright, I'm impressed. We got this done in a timely manner. Well, almost done. I think I'll switch back to my weapons now. Oh. Excuse me. I don't usually burp in my videos. That's not professional at all. It's like, oh, it did a wall kick there. It's like a DSP. Good old Darkside Phil burping in his videos. Literally every single video. It gets really annoying to hear after a while. Sounds like she's gonna cry. She's like, ah! Go get Gil. Every time I say Gil, I think of Gil from The Simpsons. Oh, good old Gil. Alright, once we hit the security room, I'll stop, because... Well, maybe not stop recording, but... Well, stop recording this video, but the videos today, I don't know. Let's see how much trouble we'll have here. Mindy's up. Seem to be having some trouble here.
Follow me!
That was a trick. Oh, now Mindy's back down. Everyone's just pushing each other around. Gil Jimenez. Quite a name. So, it is currently 10 o'clock in game time. We start at 11, I believe. Yeah, at 11. So, I'll stop the video here, and I'll start recording once it's time to do the mission. So, until then, thanks for watching this vid. I hope you enjoyed it, and stay tuned for the next part.